Hello again, viewers, and greetings, fellow space travelers. This is Thorn of Night. Ooh. This seemed a lot farther than usual. Strange. And welcome to another episode on the Performium Skyblock server. And I'm down here at my... what will become my primary activity center for me. Floating bark in the making. And a couple of things I wanted to tell you. First off, by the addition of just a repeater, this works. The button is right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It should not have any issue at all powering this, but for whatever reason, it did in the video about the making of, or the transference of my farm to down here. So, adding the repeater fixed that problem for good, I hope. I don't know what the deal was, but it's taken care of. Also down here, I have another little small thing that I've added. And this is a bit of an experiment that I had a couple people help me test. And they, for whatever reason, I don't know why, they just didn't want to go into the closet where this armor stand is and stand there with the door shut and wait for something to happen. I mean, what's wrong with this? There's nothing... Okay, well, maybe those could have arrows or fire charge. No, there's nothing wrong with this. Nothing scary at all. Okay, maybe a little bit. But, the reason why I'm showing you this creation is because I just learned about this. I saw it, I think, Unspeakable Gaming or some other person's video that was doing a tour of a redstone mansion or redstone underwater city or something. They showed something that I did not know. If you take armor and put it into an armor, or put it into a dispenser, and you power that dispenser onto either a player, let me get rid of this, a player or an armor stand, it'll transfer onto them. Oh, why did I hit that again? So, you can have a person in here and then, poof, they're wearing armor. If they were unarmed before, or if they were unclad before. But I have an idea that I want to do with this, and it's not going to necessarily involve armor, but instead, it is going to involve scaring the pants off of someone. We've got, well, let's see here, I can move the button there, I guess. Thunder. There. If you walk past... Oh, hold on. I'm getting asked something. Sorry about that. I had to go see what I was being asked. Anyway, I moved the button, and if you are, say, walking past an alcove in a dark walkway, and you step on a pressure plate, and you happen to look over and see... the dragon head. Oh, that was horrible. There we go. You happen to see the dragon head appear next to you. Like that. Just poof. Especially if it accompanies some sort of loud noise. That would be amazing. I think. I don't know. But I would like to think that walking past an armor stand that was completely unclad, or walking past a hole. Like, if I just had this and then a slab up there and just an opening, just had it backlit, and this was all, I don't know, coal blocks or something. Something really dark. And then all of a sudden, poof, dragon head. especially if it accompanied some sort of noise. I don't know about you, but I'd probably jump a little if I didn't know it was coming. It'd be something a little fun to add to, oh, I don't know, a scary attraction up there. I could charge some sort of, like, your pay a diamond or pay an emerald or something, go through, and that would compensate me for having to go through and reset all the little contraptions and doohickeys that I will be putting in there. Just an idea for a funhouse attraction. Dragon head on an armor stand just appearing from a button press. Something kind of cool. Anyway, today I think I am going to either have to revert to doing another dispenser thing, the random selection of options, or I might have an idea about if not a long term, then at least a temporary readjustment of my tree farm into something that I can better optimize for space, my small tree farm. Because I have, let's go up there. I have all this space taken up with just 16 trees and I have to wait for them to grow. If, however, I set up a system like I did the cobblestone generation on Night Hunter 87's island, then I could stand, here, plant saplings, have a dispenser bone millet, and as soon as it grows, then the whole trunk, and I'd have to put a lid on it so I didn't get, giant trees, but I would have the whole trunk get scooted over, and it would make a line of trunks, I think 11 long, and then all those trunks could get pushed into a cube, and then all I'd have to do afterwards is put some leaves on the very top and shear them that way. I think that's probably going to be much more space and time efficient, because yeah, I would be using bone meal to rapidly grow the trees, but let's see here. Let me count this. If I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for all the redstone, and then it would be here for starting. So let's say there's where the sapling would grow, and the dispenser would be here, so I could, if I had a block there, I could, and this was dirt, I could put a sapling on the side of a glass block and it would plant right there, and then this would just constantly be repeating click click click. I would have to be powering it from this side, actually. So, there we go. I could be standing here, have slabs over my head so I don't leaf suffocate, and just repeatedly plant saplings in there over and over again, and then the wall here would push the trunks this way, and we'd go 1, 2, 11, not nearly as far as this, and then 1, 2, 12, it would come to here. Okay, so it would take up about the same amount of space, but I would get 132? Yeah, 132 trees worth of logs, as opposed to just 16 trees worth of logs in basically the same space. And because of bone meal, it would happen so much faster. The only downside is I would have to have much more bone meal handy all the time in order to do it. And oh my goodness! I need to offload some plain bows again. Yikes. But the good news is, I also have, even if I'm not going to do that, I could do the cobblestone generator, same sort of idea as the one for Night Hunter. Just go ahead and put that somewhere, at least temporarily, so I have one. And I could, at that point, know how much redstone I'm going to be looking forward to keeping on hand at any given time. Because that's another one of my concerns, is I have been selling the redstone. I've not restocked it myself, but I have been selling plenty of redstone. I don't know if it's going to be worth keeping the shop, because I don't know if people are going to be selling back to me. I do know that I have gone up in monies a little bit since I was on last. People have also been buying diamonds. Not selling, but buying. People have been buying iron, too. That's kind of nice. But, there are several things that I could be doing. But I do need to keep on top of my redstone supply, because I left myself with a stack of redstone blocks. It'll last me for a lot of projects, but once I build these automated machines, the trunk mover and the cobblestone sheet mover and all that, I'm going to start really dipping into it, because it's going to be pistons and torches and repeaters and things all over the place. So that's going to take a lot of redstone. So I'm going to have to do some thinking, and probably it will be one of the devices today. We will see. But whatever the case may be, you'll find out here in just a bit. I'll be back. Minor distraction here. And what would my videos be without minor distractions? I am visiting the island of one named Derpsy, who I think I just heard take some damage up there. And I have now seen evidence that the bedrock, and this is in fact bedrock for their island, the bedrock is a transparent block, which will allow the beacon to go through, which means you can put beacons in the nether. Interesting. Did not know that. I think I had heard something about putting a beacon in the nether, but I don't think I saw any evidence that it would work or something like that. Not sure. Anyway, what is... Oh, they are the ones shooting the arrows themselves. No, no. I don't want to chance it. Okay, well, I'm going back to work. I just wanted you to see the bedrock beacon thing. I have, however, decided I am going to get to work on the cobblestone sheet maker so I can start generating that, because that's the thing that I run out of the most often and the thing that I need a lot of anyway. So, cobblestone it is. Be right back. Okie dokie. Oh, there I said okie dokie again. Didn't even try. Okay. I have the beginnings of the cobblestone gen. I decided instead of having a secondary flotilla thing over there, I'm just going to extend this bark back. And what that means is I could have room for something else under here, or I could just have this on a platform that's slightly overhanging the end of the air bladder. And I am doing just a sheet, not going to make a cube of them. That way I can just come down every once in a while and it's already got 130, so like two stacks almost, well, more than two stacks of cobblestone ready for me to go. But now I just want you to see, I've sort of had to design this from the back to the front, unfortunately, and I just want you to see me do the last little bit of installation for the clock that I like to design, or I like to include, rather. I came up with this clock back when they added repeaters, and I have used it ever since. But let's see here. I need that block, and that block. that. Now, the way this works is I'm going to put a redstone torch on that. And that pushes that guy. Then I'm going to put a repeater there on the slowest setting. I need to have a way to turn this off. Actually, I want this over here. And then there we go. Now that's going to just keep pushing this out until it gets to a second contraption that I'm going to add here. This is just like, wait, I'm being pushed. This is just like what I did on Night Hunters, only now I'm finally adding one on my own. But I just want you to see this. It's nice and compact. And there we go. It's blinking away. But I can just turn it off at any point. But I just wanted you to see. This is going to be here. It's going to be inside the confines of the ship. And it's going to be, let's see here. Yeah. Under my house, for sure. And this part's going to be even farther. This will actually be under the park itself. So this ship down here is going to be turning into a place where I'm going to be spending a lot more time. It's going to have the farms. It's going to have more cobbled gen there. I'm going to also have other little things for me to work on and do. That way I can spend time down here. And I'm probably going to be restricting the access, or maybe just changing it so it isn't this tube that goes all the way down like that. Probably have a landing pad up here, like a bounce pad. There we go. I could do a bounce pad there, and then people could walk down the stairs. That way the tube doesn't go all the way down, and I can readjust this. It doesn't have to be like that. So I have some plans for it, but for today, for right now, I'm working on this. And then after I get done with this, we'll see. I might even also do the tree farm. We will find out. But update over. Getting back to work. See you in a bit. Okay, couple new things. I got the machine up and running. And this is just like the setup that I have over at Night Hunters. But like I was saying, I had to do it sort of sideways, or from the back to the front, I guess, is a better way of putting it. I had to figure out how I was going to arrange this and where all these parts were going to be before I set this in place, but I also had to know how much space I needed here and all that, so I knew this had to be 5 blocks away from the wall. Woo. There we go. But it is, here, let me turn this off. There we go. Much more quiet. Okay. This is going to have to be lit, probably. This is going to, since it's machines, it's going to all, by design, be iron blocks. I want this part to be a mechanism. And so I'm using iron blocks to do this. It has nothing to do with the island level. It's just for aesthetics, for the sole purpose that this is a machine that's running. So I wanted it to all be blocks of iron. A, because I have the blocks of iron, and B, because it fits. It's a machine. It does ka-chunky-chunky stuff. And so now what I have to do is come up under here, make the platform to walk on. That's going to be wood. The walls are all going to be wood. And as a matter of fact, let's see here. What is, okay, that's got wood under it, so I can go ahead and woodify that. There we go. Now the reason why I've decided to go with wood for this is so that if I am going to be down here digging, at least if I overdig a little, the wood isn't going to be a problem. So the wood is actually going to also be coming up here. As a matter of fact, why don't I go ahead and do that? Like so. This can't be wood because that's the cobblestone that's going to be going out. But the rest of this, the floor, the walls, everything else, that's going to be wood. And I think, let's see here. No, not here. That won't do any good. This one is going to be iron because it is part of the machine. But everything else here, I think this is good. All right. Now, this is going to be eye level right here. And then the floor is going to be this. So I can come in here and dig. Next thing I'm going to have to do... Oh, it's Manaya. Hello. Next thing I'm going to have to do is make sure that the top of this is covered in slabs so things won't spawn on it. And then encase it in the ship itself. And that's part of the reason why I have it one farther in than this edge here. I do have to let this run to fill this out, so that's what I'm going to do. Now, a couple pieces of news. Let me get out of the ka-chunk-ka-chunks. I apparently made an impression on Night Hunter there. Oh, hold on. Let me answer this question. Actually, no, let me answer this question in chat. This is the impression that I made on Night Hunter. Let's see here. Respond. It has... They are asking how much water I need for Squid to show. To be below... Y equals 62 and above Y equals 46. Any amount will do. Oh, it didn't show up there. So, instead, I guess I'll have to do this. I'll just say rar, because, and you'll understand why in just a moment, rar. They bought me dragon rank. It doesn't really do anything other than make the letters in front of my name be purple and say dragon, but rar. Yay, he says. Ah, this is so surreal to me. Another thing that they bought is P time. Now, if I go slash P time, it'll say how much or what the time is and what that is in game and all that. But I can go P time night and I can set it visibly for me. I can set it to night or I can go P time day. And it changes it to daylight for me. This is... when you see this, if you see this, thank you a million times again. But, wow. This is... I'm floored. Speaking of floors, though, another thing that has happened. Jojo Champ is beginning... with helping on a project. Okay, so they came all the way over here. I am transitioning my platform. Oh! There we go. I am transitioning my platform to prepare it for the maze. And Jojo wanted to help with that. Or Jojo actually wanted just something to do, and so they're helping with this. And this is going to just be two layers of stairs all the way around the outside. And let me show you when this, if you want to repeat this sort of pattern, when you get that, and it's inevitably going to happen as you're building this sort of thing, when you get that, just take the nearest corner out and replace it, and it will fix this. So, boop, and... That's how you fix those. But it's going to, in between, have these other, it can be just some other type of block, but I'm also going to put carpet on top of it. That way, nothing at all will spawn anywhere. And then I'm going to design the maze based on these grid sizes. These will be the walls here, and then people will be running around in maybe a 3 or a 4 tall room, and the rooms will be one unit of the maze. And I'm doing it like this so that there's no dips for falling down, no little sinkholes or whatever. It is just half a step gap between, or half a block or whatever you want to say. And then the carpet doesn't raise your height, so you will just be able to walk straight across. In the rooms that interchange, I will have like one block there, and then there will be walls. But this whole floor down here is going to be one giant maze, and it's going to probably take a while to go through. I have not fully designed the look of each of the rooms. I might do the same room for all of them, but then again, I might do like a thematic room that can sort of guide the person to get closer or farther from the exit. Like, I might do some getting warmer, getting colder kind of theme. I don't know. I haven't fully decided yet. I will have to look at how many spots there are going to be on the whole thing. It's going to take a while, even knowing how to go through. Look at that. That's going to be one cell. And then it's going to fill the whole floor here. It's going to be busy. But that's a huge future project. Right now, I need to get finished on this thing here. And that is why I need slabs. Oops, 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 oops. So there we go. That's happening. Even though it's daytime for me, those things can spawn there. But now that this came all the way over here, I can see how much space I needed. Interesting. I might want to... Oh no, what I could do is just leave this as the side wall. No, I can work with this. Because this has to be inside the ship's wall no matter what. Alright. But I can work with this here. This isn't going to be a problem. I can deal with this. Anyway, I'm going to get back to work, deal with the darkness here, and make some slabs and such. I will be back. Alright. Unfortunately, the pee time doesn't affect the weather. I'm pretty sure I've had it explained to me that pee weather isn't an option. But we've got a completed room here. Now what I'm going to do is make the back end of the ship one wider. So instead of being there for the sidewall, it's going to be there anyway. What that means is I can make this be a little thicker. I can build the outside wall of this and then retain the cobblestone on the inside as far as spacing is concerned, and then come back later and replace it with some other material of wood or whatever. But now I don't have to worry about the extra width. And that's a good thing. But let's come in here. I'm going to change the floor eventually, but we've got this room. I've turned the machine off for now, so there isn't ka-chunk ka-chunk going on. The glass is obviously needed for pushing all this stuff down. Well, only this glass is necessary, I guess. But just to make it nice and even looking, I have the glass all the way down. Because why not? This part out here, I'm going to have to enclose. As a matter of fact, let's get out there. And once again, this is still going to be inside the confines of the ship, but for sure, I'm going to have the back of the ship be there. Now, it's going to be rounded off, and it's going to be like a ship, but this is just going to be a part of the ship. Oh, that means I'm going to have to probably put the glowstone symmetrically over there if I want it to look right. The glowstone, obviously, there doesn't need to be any light in here, because nothing will spawn on these slabs. Stuff can spawn here, if I don't remember to turn this on, but no, it won't, for one thing. And another, it's dark. It is very dark in here. Without these glowstone coming in here and looking around, I realize just how extraordinarily dark it is once I put this ceiling on. So that's what the glowstone's for. It's so I can see while I'm harvesting the cobblestone. Now I'm going to let this run, and it's going to probably be... Oh, it stopped raining. Did it? No. It's still raining. I'm going to just have this constantly on. The only reason why I needed to turn it off was A, for not having to speak over it, and B, for getting it to set up the way I want it to. I didn't want to keep getting pushed around by cobblestone. But that is the extent of the machine. I can now just walk away, and when I come back, that will produce plenty of cobblestone. It will fill this whole thing. I will get 2 stacks worth. I came back and harvested the whole thing. A little more than 2 stacks, actually, because there was 11. And, yeah. There we go. Let's see it on the inside. See it in action. Server ping is an issue sometimes. That is why I have the... Whoa! Hi, duck! That is why I have the double sequence loop there. How on earth? Hold on. Something is amiss. I'm confused. Why is there more glass? How is that a thing? Okay, I'm going to have to do some more fiddling, but that'll have to wait. I'm going to go ahead and wrap up here with the mystery left unsolved. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please feel free to leave a message in the comment section below, and I will be more than happy to respond if I can. And if you like this video and you like what I'm doing here, please feel free to give a like. I do appreciate that, and it does help. And if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe so you know when my future stuff comes out. But I'm going to let you go so I can figure the rest of this out. Thank you once again for watching. This is Thorn of Night on the Performium Skyblock server. And I have a guest. I will talk to you later.